with the rise of shared economy, and in past 3, 4, 5 years, we have seen a very drastic shift into the entire shared economy kind of a thing. Companies like Uber, Ola, Airbnb, they've disrupted the market, and people don't want to invest, as in don't want to take product or get something full time, but want to, you know, use it wherever they want. Even if you look into the car segment, you know, company like Cadillac has recently started subscription services. If you look at softwares, SaaS-based softwares have, you know, gone to a different level now. You can get a world-class software as cheap as $2, $3, $5, you know, a month. So there's a very drastic shift into the shared economy, and similar concept is being applied. So if you look at the market scenario now, I personally believe that freelancing, automation, robotics is on the rise, and this is going to disrupt the entire market. So growth stage startups, number one, yes, they can and need to, you know, have freelancers on board. I also believe that this is going to increase with time because of the dearth of talent pool. So if you see in past 3, 4, 5, 10 years, a lot of startups are coming out to tier 2 and tier 3 cities, wherein you do not have the right talent pool available. And the biggest problem I see with hiring the right talent pool is that there's a lot of costs associated when you are bringing them down to your own town. And so a lot of transport and shifting costs are available. Plus, a lot of companies do not want to hire that high cost talent pool. They can work at a very early stage or at a growth stage. They can work with okay kind of talent, but they only need it wherever required, like more like a plug and play. So it's going to increase with time, I believe. And we've seen this happening from quite a long time now. And yes, they should basically be getting in freelancers wherever they need. I have seen a significant growth in the number of number one freelancers available and people doing freelancing. And I've also seen a lot of, you know, growth stage startups trying to opt for freelancers, because a lot of growth stage startups do not want to hire full-time employees or want to work with a limited workforce, and they want people wherever they need plug-and-play kind of a functionality available. That is number one. Number two, that a lot of talented pool which is not available in tier 2 and tier 3 cities, you know, bringing them to tier 2, 3 cities is going to cost them a lot more money which they can't afford. So I know a lot of companies who are using these freelancers through multiple platforms whenever they need it, and you know, they can just pay them per hour basis. Shared economy has been on the rise. If you look at the entire scenario, like companies like Uber and Ola, companies like Airbnb, you know, all of these companies have somewhere change the entire market condition. So shared economy is in the boom. Co-working spaces, right? It's all shared economy. So similarly, freelancer is a part of this bigger shared economy, and this is going to increase with time. And if I have to give you a number, I think a lot of companies I see are using freelance workforce for their extra projects or even for the full-time kind of a thing, wherein they only need them for a couple of hours, and they can just plug and play wherever required. Let us try to understand how freelancers function. If I have to hire a freelancer, I have multiple platforms available. So hiring freelancer is number one, either through reference that, hey, you were using some XYZ freelancer, you want to hire him, number one. Number two, or you go to some third party platform and post your job requirement, and you hire a freelancer based upon either reviews and rating or based upon the quotation he has given you, and then it's a gut feeling kind of a decision. So you are hiring somebody unknown whom you don't even know, whom you have never worked before. This is one of the biggest flaw I believe into the entire freelancing hiring process, number one. Number two, look at the problem in the engagement model. So the engagement model is also very problematic. If you look at the problem from the company side, companies, number one, do not trust, have a trust issues with freelancers, they have security issues with freelancers, and number three, they have a retention issue. Their work sometimes go continuously to them, sometimes does not go continuously to them. And the management issue, they don't know how to manage freelance workforce because they're not the part of the full time. So HR does not know how to manage freelancers because the policies are going to be absolutely different for them, right? HR is again, so our system has never taught HR to how to manage freelancers. They know how to manage full-time employees, but they don't know how to manage freelancers. If you look at it from freelancer side, I meet a lot of freelancers. I day in, day out work with freelancers, and I have been a freelancer myself when I started my career. The biggest problem I as a freelancer, and now I see all these young guys, you know, who want to freelance, is that number one, they say that the client does not know how to give a critical feedback. So the feedback is either acha hai, bura hai, I like it, I do not like it, make it more yellow, more blue, more red, or you know, I don't like it, but it's not a very critical feedback what freelancer is looking at.